Welcome back, guys. Today we'll be making catfish pepper soup with sweet potatoes. Let's get started. Okay, so we're starting with cooking our potatoes first, and we are just going to parboil this. We don't need it to be totally cooked. We just want to reduce the starch. Potatoes are naturally thickening agent, and I do not like my pepper soup with a super thick consistency. It really makes the pepper soup tiring while you are eating. But if you do like the thick consistency, you can just keep this part and cook the potatoes together with your pepper soup. And then we'll add our pepper into the boiling water. This pepper is just majorly red pepper and onion. That's rodo and onion, and the quantity depends on the amount of pepper that you can consume personally. So the more pepper you can consume, the more pepper that should go in your soup. We are going to add vegetable oil, just a little, not too much, just a little oil. After that, we're going to add our seasoning cubes in the soup, and then we'll add salt to taste and the pepper soup spice. You can get this at a regular store, and then we'll give it a nice stir. I can smell it, I love it. Then our crayfish, blended crayfish, gives your pepper soup a special kind of flavor. Then now we'll put in the fish. Try not to put the fish too closely so that you don't get the fish broken while you're trying to stir or while you're trying to bring them out. We are going to let our fish cook for about 8 to 10 minutes, after which we're going to add our scent leaf, already sliced and washed. That scent leaf, a fearing, and then we're going to put our potatoes, the parboiled potatoes. At this point is where you want to put it, so it's not going to put too much starch in the soup. The soup is not going to come out looking too thick, so that's the point of parboiling. But if you want your soup to be thick, you can just cook the potatoes together with the soup, like after putting the pepper and your seasoning, before you put the fish or immediately after you put the fish. So now I'm going to just garnish this with some sliced onion. Yeah, I like the flavor of the onion. We will leave the soup to cook for another 5 minutes on low heat, and at that time our sweet potato and catfish pepper soup is going to be ready to consume. And here we go. Oh my god, can you see the consistency we're talking about? It is not too watery and not too thick. Now that we're done preparing our pepper soup, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, like and comment on this video. Thanks for watching, and enjoy.